Hello everyone, welcome to Go Get My Guru. In this video, you will be learning about Python exception handling using try and except blocks. So before moving with today's session, let's quickly take a look at the agenda for today. In today's session, we'll be discussing about how to handle exceptions using try and except clause, and also we'll see try block with multiple except blocks and try except with else block, and we'll see try and finally block. So let's get started with our first topic, that is try and except clause. I hope all of you have watched our previous video on Python exception handling. If so, you might have understood why there is a need for exception handling. So let me just quickly recap the concept again. We had written a program in our previous video to perform division operation. So this is the program we had written. Observe here at line number 4 and line number 5, we are printing two statements. One for result of division and one more statement is program not halted. Let's run this program. So here you can see that enter the numerator and denominator I'll enter as 6. You can observe the result of division is 2, and also it is printing one more print statement, that is program not halted. Now we had provided a correct input for both numerator and denominator, that's why it is giving us the exact result. Let's run the program once again. This time I'll enter denominator as 0 and let's check what happens. You can see that once I enter the denominator 0, it is throwing an error, traceback error, that is 0 division by 0. So this is an exception. Here comes the exception handling concept, because these two, that is result of division and program not halted, are not getting printed. That means the program is getting halted once control comes to the computing of result, that is division operation. Let's go back to code. So when the control came here at line number 3, it is getting halted because it is raising an exception. So after this line number 3, 4 and 5 are not getting printed. So this is not advisable in real time programming. That's why you need to handle the exceptions. So let's discuss handling exceptions with try and except block. So try is a keyword in Python which is used to handle the exceptions. So try and followed by colon is the syntax for try block. Now you need to follow the indentation here. So I am putting 4 lines of code in my try block, which is performing division operation, because this was the code which was raising an exception. Now once you have written the try block, you need to write except block, except exception, and then here I'll put one more print function to print denominator cannot be 0. So what is this exception? Exception is a common base class for all the exceptions. That means regardless of what exception is raised, this except block will be handling all types of exception, be it a zero division error, type error, value error, whatever the exception may be. So let's first run this and check the output. It's asking us to enter the numerator, I'll enter as 12, and the denominator, I'll enter as 0. Now you can see that we did not get traceback error. Instead, we are getting denominator cannot be 0, and also program not halted statement is getting printed. That means our exception is handled properly. So let's understand the flow of this try and except block. What happens here? When I enter a numerator value, control goes to line number 3, it takes the denominator value, and in line number 4, it is trying to perform division operation. So when it tried to perform division operation, since we have provided denominator value as 0, it is raising an exception. So from line number 4, the control moves to line number 6, that is except block. Here the exception is handled, and whatever the print statement we are providing, that is getting printed. Once the accept block completes its execution, again the control moves back to line number 5, executes this print function, and then control comes out of this try and accept block, and then line number 8 is getting printed. I hope all of you are clear with the flow of this try and accept block. Now, since here I am defining exception, so it is going to handle all the exception. So instead of exception, I'll write it as zero division error. That means this block accept block is executing whenever the zero division exception is raised. Let's quickly run the program again and check what happens. So enter the numerator 12, denominator 0. So you can see that we are getting the same result. So when I had provided exception here, it was handling all types of exceptions. Here particularly I am mentioning zero division error, and this tells that this accept block is only for zero division error. If you want to know the hierarchy of these exceptions, just import built-ins and then type help parenthesis built-ins, which gives you all the inbuilt exceptions. Exception is a base class for all types of exception. And then if you look at here, arithmetic error, this is a class and its child classes are zero division error, overflow error, floating point error. Class exception, it is going to handle all these types of exceptions regardless of which exception has been raised. I hope you are clear with this. So exception with a variable. Let's discuss that. Remember, whenever any exception is raised, an object is created. So zero division error as E. So what does this mean? Here E is nothing but reference to the object created by this exception. Let me give here one more print function, that is print, I'll give E. Now let's run this and check what happens. So here it is asking us to enter numerator and then denominator, I'll enter as 0. Here you can see that division by 0. So why it is coming so? Let's go back to code. So whenever I try to print the E, it is printing the details of the exception raised. I hope you are clear with this try and accept clause, its syntax, how to make use of accept block with exception and exception name, as well as exception with a variable. So let's move on to our next topic. Let's discuss about try with multiple accept block. So observe here, I am entering numerator and denominator value in terms of integer. Now let me change this as zero division error itself. So this print E goes off. Now let's run this as it is first. So here again enter the numerator value and then enter the denominator value. This time I'll enter it as float value. So now here you can see that we have got traceback error and our program is getting halted again. That means we have not handled this particular exception. That is, what is the exception here? Exception here is value error, invalid literal for integer. We can write one more except block to handle that exception. So except, so what was our error there? It was value error. Now let's print one more statement, that is provide valid input. So let's run this and check whether this except block handles the error we had committed earlier. So numerator, now denominator, I'll enter as float value. Now you can see that it is handling exception and telling that provide a valid input. You can observe that here we are defining two accept blocks for this single code. Since the code in the try block is throwing two types of exceptions, one is zero division error, and if the user does not enter a valid input, it is throwing value error. I hope you are clear with this multiple accept blocks. To understand this more clearly, Let's run this again. So here you can see it is asking us to enter numerator and denominator. This time I'll enter denominator as 0. You can see that now it is throwing denominator cannot be 0. So what exactly is happening? So when the control is at line number 4, it sees the denominator value is 0. So it comes to the except 0 division block, that is at line number 6. If I enter the invalid input, that is float value, the control is moving to this except block. So what is happening? Python, whenever an exception is raised, Python virtual machine is searching for an exact exception raised. That means if the exception is raised due to 0 division error, it is executing this block. If the exception is raised because of this value error, it is executing the value error block. So here I am writing two except blocks separately. Can we write a single except block with multiple exception names? Yes, of course you can write. To do that, let's make a little change in this program. So after except, you need to provide parenthesis and then comma, one more exception name, that is value error. And now let me comment this line. So this, I'll take a variable as e here. So you can write here print exception raised is e. So what I am doing here, I am taking exception with a variable. Now let's run this and check what happens. Here I'll enter numerator again as 12, denominator as 0. Now you can observe here that it is telling exception raised is division by 0. That means division by 0, and then it is printing the statement followed by the except block. So now let's run the code again. So again here I'll provide a float value. Now exception raised is invalid literal, that is value error. I hope you are clear with how to write multiple exceptions in a single except block. So next the question comes is, whenever an exception is raised, Python virtual machine is looking at the except block. What if the exception raised is not in this except block? That means the exception raised is other than this zero division error and value error. What happens then? Then we have to write a simply except block, and then whatever the message you want to print it on the console, you can give it in the print function. So I want to give something went wrong. Whenever Python virtual machine finds there are no matching except blocks for the exception raised, finally it comes to this except block and then execute this statement written in that except block. I hope you are clear with the concept of how to write multiple except block. Let's move on to our next topic, that is try except with else clause. So what is this else clause now? Let's discuss that with an example. So here what I have done is, whenever an exception is raised, control goes to except block. Whenever exception is not raised, the control comes to else block. So in the else block, I'll just put a single print function, that is division performed successfully. Let's run this and check what happens. So here I'll enter the numerator again as 12, denominator as 2. So this time exception is not raised because 12 by 2 is 6 and it is printing division performed successfully. So what is happening here? Observe here, whenever an exception is not raised, except block is skipped and control comes to else block and checks what's there in else block. It executes the else block. Let's move on to our next topic. So we know what is try block. Now we know what is try block, and now we'll understand why we use finally block. As I have said in the previous video, finally block will always be executed regardless of the exception. This finally block is useful whenever you are performing database operation or remote file operation. So let me take a try block here. In this try block, I am going to open a file. Open sample.txt. And this I am going to open in read mode. So this file is already present in the directory. You can see here sample.txt. Now, I'll take one more try block. In this try block, I'll try to write to the sample.txt. So f.write, I'm going to write, I am writing to the sample file. So now, before this accept block, I'm going to write finally block. So in this finally block, I'm going to close the file and print a message on console that file is closed. And now here I'll write accept block. So in this accept block, I'm going to handle the exception. Print content cannot be returned to the file. So it's showing a red line here now. So let's run the program first and check what happens. Here you can see that file is closed. That is because of finally block. And then content cannot be returned to the file. So we are getting these two messages on console. What does that mean? That is because here I am opening a file in read mode. So in the second block, one, when I am trying to write a file opened in the read mode, it is raising an exception. So before raising an exception, finally block will always be executed regardless of the exception. So in the finally block, I am putting a code to close the file. So now, instead of read mode, I'll make it as write mode. Let's run this now and check what happens. Now you can see that file is closed, getting executed because regardless of the exception is raised. Exception is not raised here because we are opening a file in write mode and then we are trying to write it to that file. This confirms that finally block is always executed regardless of the exceptions. I hope you're clear with the concept of exception handling with try except block.
If you like our videos to support us, leave us a feedback in the comment section. Have you subscribed to our channel? If not, request you to click on subscribe button and hit the bell icon to receive regular updates. Thanks for watching. We'll see you again in the next session. Keep coding. Happy learning.